Okay, welcome everyone. This talk is meant to be on reproducible builds. There was one session last year. I hope most of you might have seen it because this time we have a little less time to cover it. And what's that about? We have all the software coming from developers that commit to Git repos where it's secured by hash sums, they package it up through tar and sign it hopefully, and then the package is wrote into OBS, and then some magic happens and it goes out to the mirrors. But the tricky part is the magic that happens. Do we know if it doesn't insert backdoors? And to find out, we can use reproducible builds, because when we really have that, everyone can build the same software at his home machine, where he can control how it's built, and if it produces identical results, bit by bit, identically, ideally, then it's the same and can't contain any backdoors that are inserted only on the build service. And there's also some second consideration where we apply some filters because we know we have the build hostname in the RPMs, and currently it's still needed because we want to build know where an RPM was built to trace down errors that are from specific build hosts. So we have this build compare, and it knows to filter out certain differences. So why is it good? So first, we need less trust in the build hosts and the OBS. Also, if we produce identical binaries, we know, okay, it's the same, so we don't have to republish it, and we don't have to build the depending packages, like we have a new Python, and then we don't have to build all the Python modules on top and these things. So we get less load on the build servers. For the update channels, we have Delta RPMs, and they become smaller when we have smaller diffs. Because normally, if you don't have any change, you have zero diff. But if you have a change, you have only the small diff, usually. And sometimes we even find bugs that are completely unrelated, like these two here, that screwed up some packages. They didn't throw an error, they just produced packages, but the packages contained incorrect data. And each time a bit different, and that's why I noticed them and we got them fixed. Yeah, and what typically prevents packages from being reproducible is timestamps. That's easy to fix because we have a variable called source date epoch, and we replace the current time with that value, and then we always have this one value. And currently, that comes out of the latest changelog entry date from the RPM changelog. And that's nice. That's a patch I brought upstream to RPM. They took it and it works. Sometimes packages put rebuild counters in there, but it's only very few. And if you really try to build an identical package, you set the rebuild counter to the identical value anyway, so that it doesn't matter so much. The .o file order affects some dozen packages I found, maybe even 90, and I started to submit some fixes there. We will see some more on the next slide, and a few packages even did compile time CPU detection. That's very broken because if you build it on a very modern machine, it won't run on older machines because those older machines don't support the CPU instructions that are compiled in then. So that's a real bug and needs to be fixed anyway. So, no, come on, yeah. And during the last year, we discovered some new sources of randomness or non-determinism inserted. One is profile-based optimizations, which is a feature of GCC where you build your software with some special flags, then you run it a bit and it generates some counters of which functions were used and what it did. And then you build it again using this information from the stuff in between. And it turned out that some packages like gzip and bash and stuff did stuff in between that produced differing counters between different builds, and these different counters produce different optimizations in GCC output. And that's a bit tricky because, either you completely drop the optimizations, but then your software runs slower, or you make really sure that the stuff you do to run your software always happens in exactly the same way. And that can be a bit tricky to get right. For example, with gzip, I found that even the file name you give it matters, because there's some toLower function. The toLower function depends on if you have uppercase letters or lowercase letters in your file name, and the temp files had sometimes one and sometimes the other. Okay, yeah, RPM. RPM is tricky because it has sizes for directories. You don't see it in RPMQL, that's always zero, but in the actual binary, they have sizes, and sometimes they vary because your file system grows when you add files and it doesn't shrink when you remove files again. And so, and even ghost files, which are not actually part of your package, are tracked with a size and a checksum even. So there were some variations, and I guess I will propose some patches to get rid of these when we want to do reproducible builds. And the other part, the lower part here, is about the link order. So many packages have in the makefiles a dollar wildcard, something C, and then they produce a list of O files from that. And then they link these O files into their result binary. And if they just do it as on the left side, it will be a random order. And the linker optimizes in different ways and sorts the functions in different ways. So if you want to really have reproducible builds, you need to do a sort, and in Python, a sorted list. And even the Boost only, no, yeah, Boost owns a build system called Gem, had the same problem. So I did one patch to one usage there. And what other? There's another build system called BAM, and it has exactly the same problem. And the fun part is, I saw the Python glob. There's a libc function called glob, and that does sort by default, but the Python glob is not using the libc glob, so that's why it doesn't have it. And apparently, make and boost, they all don't use the libc glob for some reason. Not sure why. Yeah, so a lot of work I did. Plenty submit requests filed for OpenSUSE. That's, for example, when we had stuff in the spec files that needed fixing, like calling gzip without the minus n option. So then I just added minus n to leave out the current time. And then it became reproducible. That were easy fixes, and a lot of upstream fixes actually went in already, many dozens. And sometimes I just try bugs because I can't figure out how to fix it, and then I let others have a look at the code and decide how to get it right. Okay, so if you want to test out if a package builds reproducibly or why it doesn't, then you can use my Git repo, which is there, nicely named to remember reproducible OpenSUSE. There's also this presentation's source code in Markdown in there, using this nice script called odpdown to render it into OpenOffice. And apart from that, there's also a wiki page on the OpenSUSE wiki giving some pointers to the upstream reproducible builds.org website, and some more hints. Yeah, but the stuff I work on is a Git repo mostly, and there's a README telling you how to use it. Yeah, I also did some patches to OC and build to make it easier to do this, mostly to pass flex from OC to build to KVM. And telling KVM that it's already 2018 and I want to build this package in 2018. And then I find Java packages to say documentation copyright 2018, which is interesting. But yeah, they do. And others do as well. Yeah. And last year, the state was that I was able to build one package twice, and it produced the identical results. And this year, I built 9,000 something of our 11,000 factory packages, and they produced identical results. So that's quite good. There are some tweaks that are not in factory yet, like the host name, the build host reproducible. That's only in the project where I built currently. But at some future point in time, we might have it in factory if we want to. And the other one that's not in factory yet is clamp m time that modifies timestamps in RPM and makes sure that they're not the current time, but change log time. So older timestamps will remain as they are, but anything that's newer than change log time, that gets set exactly to change log time, and then you get reproducible bits for that one. And yeah, the plan is to work some more on it. Maybe you want to work on some build compare issues as well. And finally, when we're all done, we might be able to have a whole factory with all packages building bit identical RPMs, and it would be quite nice to see that. And until we are there, I keep publishing on my web server called rb.zq1.de some build results, and the latest one is always the symlink here called factory, which is actually a symlink to this version. And in here are the diffs I get from building these few thousand packages that are not yet reproducible. And in there you can see what exactly differed, and maybe fix it yourself. But oh yeah, Haskell is still an issue. Yeah, but also others. So it's not limited to some. Java is sometimes tricky. KDE has a sorting problem where I don't know exactly where it comes from. So I'm looking for some input there. But yeah, overall, it's progressing. It's getting better. And you're finding more fixes over time. So questions so far? There's one.
If any file has a date in future, then you can get very very wrong results for some build dates.
Okay, so if our tarball contained a file that had a date in future,
if the source contains a date in future,
yes, then
that very wrong things can happen. So it's good to check source. And. And there are some sources of unreproducibility that cannot be observed in OBS, but they can be observed when you are trying to rebuild on your local machine just by RPM build. There are, for example, language and locale settings.
Yeah.
Other problem of some spec files could be that if you have more packages installed than build requires defines, then you will get a different result than you build with just packages that are there. So so when fixing, it's good to think about building also outside the OBS.
Yeah, currently I'm doing local builds using OSC build, but that's using the same build tool behind that sets up a clean environment where you have no locale, no time zone, only the packages that are build required, except if you override it with -- no init.
Yes.
And so it's a pretty clean build environment. And yes, we are not hitting all of the issues that you could hit, but at least we are hitting the ones that are most interesting to OBS right now. So we are fixing them first, and when we are done with them, we might look further at the others, but RPM build is not that much used anymore. The last guy said OBS is so much nicer. And
For example, when I am creating spec files, then I'm explicitly writing disable some feature then we have that we don't have in build requires. So even if somebody builds it locally, it will not fail.
Yeah, that works. Okay, more questions? There's one.
Thanks. So are you doing these reproducibles currently only for x86, 64? And if not, are you seeing differences there between the various platforms that we have in OBS?
Yeah, so currently it's only this one architecture, and I think the vast majority of non-reproducibility is independent, like inserting timestamps is independent, ordering input files is independent. Linker optimizations maybe, but it might even happen on other architectures. So I think it's over 90% not depending on the architecture. So if you fix it for one, it will work for others. More questions? There's one.
Do we have this linked more visibly somewhere than just on some obscure website?
Which link exactly?
Well, for the diffs, for example, for the packages.
Okay. Where exactly would you want to wish it to have this link?
Well, for example, RPM lint gives us results in OBS and this is not visible anywhere. I'm not sure if it's anywhere centrally located, but because, for example, in Debian, when there's a QA page for a package, you get a list of is the package reproducible, and then you get a diff right in there instead of finding it in a mysterious location.
I can try to add these links in some more prominent ways, but we can discuss later.
Well, I can imagine OBS test case that it shows a warning that this package have never equal RPMs in output.
In OBS or in RPM lint?
in OBS. Probably in OBS, because OBS knows the previous result. And it could tell that it had never the same RPM as output.
Yeah, if you don't look at change logs and these things.
If OBS does sometimes rebuilds, and it compares the builds, but
yeah. So we could collect these statistics and use these as extra input. Yeah, that's true. Okay.
And a question, just another question. Do we have already reproducible builds of debug info and the debug source?
Not exactly sure. I think in my tests, I currently build without debug info, but I think it's even possible with debug info, because if your binaries are identical, your debug info will be identical as well. So I would need to check, but I think it's working. Okay, then I think time is over. So thanks for joining. Have a nice day.